Hello everybody, welcome to today's session. I am Pradeepta Kumar. So guys, this is the tutorial number 42 of AWS Cloud Detail series. On today's session, we'll discuss about one compute service, that is Amazon Elastic Container Service, known as Amazon ECS. So guys, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now for more videos related to different cloud technology, different DevOps tool, VMware administration, Linux administration, and many more latest technology. So guys, before going with the lab session, I would like to give some overview on Amazon ECS. So Amazon ECS is a container orchestration service or tool which allow you to run in Docker container or containerized application on AWS, which also provides high availability to your Docker container and or containerized application. So in the market, you will get different type of container orchestration tool known as Docker Swarm, Amazon ECS, EKS, GKE called Google Kubernetes Engine, or AKS, Azure Kubernetes Service. So Docker Swarm and GKE video has been uploaded, so you can watch that video also. And EKS and AKS, that in the next upcoming days, I am going to upload. So guys, Amazon ECS will provide two models to run your Docker container. One model run on EC2, another model is AWS Fargate. So if you are choosing run on EC2, that means you have to take care of EC2 instance. That means if any patching needed, then you have to do the patching by yourself. Okay, so AWS is not bothered about that. But if you are choosing AWS Fargate, in that case, there is no need to take care anything. So AWS will take care everything. Okay. So guys, in today's lab session, we are going to run Nginx containerized application on AWS. So for that, there is prerequisite is needed. So prerequisite is that we need to set up one machine with Docker and AWS CLI. Why Docker and AWS CLI is needed? Because we want a Nginx image, okay, Nginx Docker image, so that we can push that image to the Amazon Elastic Container Registry. Okay, so for that we need to create one machine where we need to install the Docker as well as the AWS CLI. Okay, after that, these are the configuration steps we are going to follow. First step will be repository creation, okay, in the ECR, and we'll push our Nginx image to the ECR repository. Then we'll create the cluster, then we'll create the task definition, and we'll run the task definition, then we'll go for the testing. So cluster creation, that means during the cluster creation we need to provide the how many EC2 instance we are going to add in the cluster, and what kind of AMI you are going to use. And the task definition, we need to choose that how many containers we are going to run, everything. Okay, then we'll run the task definition. Okay, so guys, this is my machine where I have installed AWS as well as the Docker. So if you have not set up any machine, you need to create one machine, okay, where you need to install the AWS and Docker. Okay, so if I'll give Docker images, so my Nginx image is available. This image we are going to post to the ECR. Okay, so what is our first step? Repository creation, okay, using ECR. So okay, this is my AWS management console. So I will click on services, then I will go to ECR. Okay, so it is a Amazon ECR called Amazon Elastic Container Registry. So I will click on get started. So I will create a repository. Suppose my ECR repo. Okay, my ECR repo, then create repository. Okay, now repository got created in ECR. So I will click on view push command, because now we need to upload our Nginx image. Okay, so for that, the first step, we need to log in to retrieve the login command to use to authenticate your Docker client to your registry. So in that case, simply I will copy the whole things, copy it, then I will paste. Okay. So this is the simply I will copy, again I will paste the output. Now we can see login succeeded. That means now we can push our image Nginx image to the ECR. Okay. So what we'll do, Docker images I've given, and what is our second step? It is saying that you need to build the image from the Docker file. Though I have already images there, so there is no need to build the image. Already image is available. Only I need to take the image and I will push. Okay. So for tagging, just I will copy this command and I will modify as per our needed. So Docker tag, then my image ID, then this is the URL for the repository, newly created repository, because we created that, right? My ECR repo, right? This is my repository, right? So this is the URL, okay? And this is the image ID, okay? This image ID going to tagged with or going to tag with this repository. Okay, now I am doing the tagging. I will give some tag name. Suppose my Nginx, image. Okay, my Nginx image, that is my tag name. Enter. Okay, if I'll give Docker images, now you can see that my Nginx image, okay, my Nginx image. So there is tagged with this repo, my repo. Another is because currently now we tagged with this repo, right? My ECR repo. Okay. So now tag done. Now we'll push the image. Okay. Simply we'll give Docker push command. Okay, so if you do not know Docker, then so just browse to my playlist. You can get multiple videos on Docker, that also you can learn. So Docker push, then I need to provide the tag name. Okay, because this is my tag, right? So Docker push, this is the URL of the repository, then this is the tag name for my image, Nginx image. Okay, now it is trying to push my Nginx image to the ECR. Okay, so it will take time to upload. Click here, let's see whether it's, as of now there is not uploaded. Just keep refreshing. It is pushing now. So depend on your network speed, so the time will vary. So pushed, it is saying pushed. That means if I refresh, okay, now you can see my Nginx image. Okay, so this is the image URI. Okay, so now we executed the second step. We created one repository in ECR, then we pushed our Nginx image to the ECR, Elastic Container Registry. Okay, the third step is our cluster creation. Okay, so third step is our cluster creation. So under Amazon ECS, so I'll click on cluster. Then I will click on create cluster. Okay, so there is a cluster template is there. So networking only, EC2 Linux plus networking, EC2 Windows. So in my case, I want to deploy my container on the Linux itself, not the Windows. So if you want to deploy your Docker container on Windows, so you can also go for the EC2 Windows plus networking. So I will go with the EC2 Linux plus networking. Click on next step. Okay, so I need to provide some cluster name, my ECS cluster. Okay, so there is provisioning model on demand and spot. So I will go with the on demand instance. Then here you need to choose the EC2 instance type. In my case, I am choosing T2 micro. So as per your requirement, so you can choose. And number of instance, I want to create two EC2 instance. So in my cluster, there will be two node cluster. Okay, so that's why I am giving number of instances two. And image ID AMI Amazon machine image. So I am going with the Amazon Linux 2 AMI. Then EBS storage. So what will be the storage size for each EC2 instance? 22 GB. It is the default only. You cannot reduce that. Okay. And key pair. Okay. I will choose, because already key pair is there, so I will choose my key. Okay. Networking. So you can create new VPC, okay, or else you can choose the default. So I will go with the default VPC. So if you want to create also, you can create new VPC as well. Okay, now I need to select subnet selection done. Then security group. Okay, you can create new security group or you can select the existing. So in my case, so I'm going with this security group, the default. So it will allow you from all it will allow the port number 80 from everybody. Okay, so this is the 0.0.0.0. okay, everybody will be connected to the port number 82 of the EC2 instance. Okay, this is a secure inbound rule. Okay, then this is the IAM rule. Okay, EC2 instance rule. So by default I will go with the by default only. Then CloudWatch container inside, that means if you want to enable that, if you want to monitor your container which is running on your EC2 instance, then you have to select. This is the latest new options available in the ECS. So if you want to monitor your container, then also you can select. Okay, I am not going to select now. Then click on create. So it is creating cluster, it is creating IAM policy, then it is launching your instance using CloudFormation stack. Okay, so if you can choose here, EC2 instance is T2 micro, desired number of instances is 2. What the image AMI we selected, that AMI Amazon image, VPC, subnet. Okay, so there is also auto scaling group. So if which is provide you the high availability. Okay, so now 3 of 3. So now cluster got created. So if I click on view cluster, okay, so you can see under task there is no task. If you click on EC2 instance, so it will take time because two EC2 instance should be created. Okay, under EC2 instance, because our cluster is two node cluster, so there should be two instance should launch, two EC2 instance should launch. Might be it will take time. Okay, so guys, you can see currently, okay, only one it is launched. Let's wait some time. So the instance count should be 2. So guys, now you can see two instance has been launched and registered container instance is 2. Okay, now cluster looks okay for us. And also if we'll go to EC2 service, because two instance launched, right? So that's why if you can see also two running instance in our case, these two instance launch. Okay, so now what is our fourth step? The step 4 is task definition creation. Okay, so now we'll go with the task definition creation. So currently there is no task. Okay, so I will click on task definition. Okay, then create task definition. Okay, so task definition specify the container information for your application. That means how many containers you want to launch. Okay, what resources they will use, how they are linked together. Okay, and also which ports in which port the application will listen. Okay, so in this case, click on create new task definition. So here, guys, in the theory session, so I told you, right, it will ask you to choose one model. One is Fargate model, another EC2 model. Okay, though we are going with the EC2, so I'll choose the EC2 model only. So next. Okay, then suppose I have to give my task definition. Okay, I'm giving the my task definition, then task rule. So I will go with the default rule on, suppose task, why task rule is needed, because if your application will, you know, suppose your application should as per your requirement, your application should, your engine's application should access to the S3, in that case we need to create a rule for that. Okay, then network mode. So there is a different type of network, bridge, host, AWS, VPC, none. So by default, the bridge, I will go with the bridge. So bridge, what is the bridge actually? So which will do the, so port mapping, okay, from your host port to your container. Okay, so that is kind of bridge, bridge will help you. So I am going with the bridge only. Okay, then task execution, I am rule, I am not going to. So task size, so you know, depend on your requirement, you have to choose. So I am choosing 400, I want to give, so I am not choosing the CPU. So task memory, memory maximum allocation for container memory reservation. So it is a memory reservation, so which you are reserving for your container. So it is, it will vary, depend on your requirement. Might be if you are, running high, then my application is needed like 1 GB or 2 GB or 10 GB or 20 GB. So accordingly you have to reserve the memory. So accordingly it will vary. So for the demo session, I'm choosing that 400. Then next is add container. So here we need to add the container, because in our case we are going to deploy the Nginx application. So my Nginx web server. Okay, my Nginx web server. Then here we need to provide the image. Okay, though my image is placed here under Amazon container service, that means on Amazon ECR. So I will just, this is the image URL, URI. So I'll just copy that image URI and I will paste. Okay, if the image, if you want to pull the images from some private repository or from Docker Hub, then you have to give the you have to provide the same information. So in my case, this is my URI. Okay, I just paste that information. So it is saying that image name is required. One second. So I'll just, what I'll do, I'll select and I will copy the, no, this is the digest. Okay, so this is the image URI. So I will copy from here itself. So I just, last time I copied from that SAR value. So that's why it was throwing an error. Okay, so now this is the image URI for my Nginx. So if this is a private repository, you have to provide the username and password, all those things. Okay, so memory limit. So if you want to, there will be hard limit and soft limit. So I am adding also soft limit. So my hard limit is 400 maximum, because I have already said that is reservation 400. If I'll give 450, that it will not take. And soft limit is 350. Okay, then port mapping, I will go with the port mapping. Suppose my the application should the application, the Nginx web server should listen on port number 80 on host port and container port also 80. Okay, then I will not go with the health check, all those things, environment. Okay, so I will I will create some other video for these are the options, because it is not needed for us. Environment, container timeout, networking, all those things which is not needed now. So if you want to add some volume also, you can add volume to the container. Okay, so I will go click on add. Okay, so now, so it is done. Okay, now I will click on create. So now our cluster created, task definition created. So what is our fifth step? Run the task definition. So now we already created If I'll click on cluster, then okay. So now if you can go to task. So now we need to run the new task because task definition created, right? So now we need to run the new task. Run new task. So I'll go with the EC2. So this is the task definition we created, right? Then cluster name, number of task. Number of task means suppose I want to run the two container because there is two machine, right? So I want to run the two container. So one machine will be run this one EC2 instance, another will be two. Okay. So AZ balance spread. So that is kind of if you are running more than 6 or 7, that kind of, you know, that time it is really helpful. Availability zone balance spread to, you know, provide the, you know, load balancing only. Okay. Then click on. Then we need to provide the task group name. Okay. Suppose my task group. Okay. My task group. Then click on run task. Okay. Now task also created. So everything done. What is our final step? We'll go for the testing whether that Nginx web server is accessible or not. So what we'll do? We'll go to our EC2 instance. So we'll take the public IP. So this is the public IP of the instance. So I'll just paste here. So now we can see this is the Nginx application is accessible from the internet. Okay, this is the default page of Nginx. Okay, so you can create your custom image, you can upload and also you can, you know, as per your need you can do. Okay, so also from the other, also from other instance also I'll try to access the my Nginx web server. Just paste it. So now also it is reachable. That means our Nginx application deployed in the Amazon ECS. So in this way you can explore yourself on Amazon ECS. You can refer the AWS document related to Amazon ECS for more knowledge. Okay, so guys, if you have any doubt, so you can give a comment section. And also if you need any type of document related to Amazon ECS, then you can reach out to me. I will help you. Thank you very much. Have a good day. Please stay tuned for next videos.